I don't think so.
Hey y'all, welcome back to the podcast.
Woohoo!
Hope you enjoyed that silhouette challenge.
You whores.
We had to, throw our little bit in the ring, put that out there.
We gave it our best shot.
Gave it our best shot. Yeah.
What can you do?
What can you do? How's your week been, Nicole? Pretty good?
It's actually been pretty good. It was like a fast week. I think I was just looking forward to the weekend a lot. So I just was excited for the weekend and just the projects that we've been working on and stuff. By the way, guys, if you're watching this is your first time, make sure to like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
In the future, we are going to get into some giveaways once we reach to a certain amount of subscribers. So yeah, make sure you do that. And also pour a drink. We are drinking. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. So I think it's 5 o'clock here.
So it actually is.
There's that. So
you're listening to Tash and Nix.
It's been a long week. Oh my gosh.
How was yours? It was pretty long?
It was pretty long. It was busy. Work was stressful.
Aww.
But we can relax.
That's the first time I've heard that from you, actually.
Yeah. Work was stressful this week.
Yeah.
It was a long ass week.
Good thing you got your drink, okay?
Gonna go do some hookah after this.
Man. I don't really do. Anyway. I don't know if y'all like hookah or not, but I don't know. I've tried it. I don't try it. But then sometimes I get sick off of it. It's for some people, and some people just can't tolerate it. So.
My friends call me the hookah queen.
Yeah.
It's the truth.
You love hookah.
Love it.
Speaking of challenges, guys. So we're going to talk about some of the challenges that we've been seeing online. Like she said, you saw our silhouette challenge and kind of get your opinions on it as well. I don't know if I'm a fan or not. I'm choking. Is anybody else? Oh, all right. Okay, that's cool. What the fuck?
Got anything else? Anyway.
Yeah.
The silhouette challenge. Nicole, you're in a happy relationship.
Am I? No, I'm sorry. Yes, I am.
Would you do the silhouette challenge?
I feel like, no. I wouldn't do it if I was single. No, I wouldn't even do it if I was single. Just because, I'm not really a social media person anyways. Surprise, surprise. But I think I wouldn't do it just, I don't know. I always think about those things are forever. You know what I mean? I don't know. I'm not saying it's a bad. I actually liked the silhouette challenge and even the busset challenge. I was here for my brown queens, but I don't know. Would you do it?
I like the little challenges. I would do it to a certain extent. Where people are doing the silhouette challenge and then it's boom, naked bitch. I wouldn't do that.
Wait, you've seen naked ones?
Yes.
Oh, I haven't seen any naked ones.
I saw the whole outline of her. Hoo-ha.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I haven't seen any of those. Yeah. I didn't know that. Okay.
Saw her ovaries in the video. she was out there for the world to see. The only thing I would be concerned about for people that do that is there's some weird ass people out there that will remove that little red filter and then they'll just be your ass and tease all over the internet.
Can you imagine being a teacher, a school teacher, and your students have your silhouette challenge? No.
Miss Tache,
is that your Gucci?
Ass on YouTube?
That's your Gucci girl. No, no. Would you do it if you, would you participate in even the busset challenge? Because I don't think that one was too terrible either, but if you were in a relationship, would you do the busset challenge?
I don't think the busset challenge was that bad either. I'm not into the challenges in general, so I can't really, speak to that.
Yeah.
And I ain't got nothing to bust it back there.
She does. You do. You have a little bit of something.
Not for the busset challenge. I need a showstopper to hit those Meg Thee Stallion knees and do that bust.
Hopefully on her birthday we'll change that. I hope she'll do a bust it challenge for everyone. But
get enough drinks in me and I'll definitely do it. But on a regular day, just a regular Wednesday, I'm not gonna do it.
I remember one time Tashé twerked in New York, you guys. If you met Tashé, you'd be like, oh, she's so quiet and such a sweet little thing. and we were in New York, and she was lit, and like she was like twerking, like she was standing in front of me twerking. I'm like, oh wait a minute, you know. And her best friend was next to me, and she's like, has she ever done this before? I'm like, no. It was so funny though, like it was, you had a good time. So
that was me in rare form. I don't know if that ever happened.
I know, like I don't think I've seen it since. So it was pretty lit. Yeah. But no, well, I don't know.
We had that Padre trip where
that was fun.
Yeah,
a little cringy on some of the videos.
It was cringy. Y'all would never see that. But
never.
It was cringy. We did the Busta challenge.
I thought about doing it actually, but like with a Caribbean twist on it. Not really showing my backside, but because either way, I said backside, like either way, I don't know, because I have kids and I don't know if I would necessarily want them to ever see that, you know, that side of me. They don't watch this, but I don't know, you know, like don't quote me on it, because if you see me doing a Busta challenge in the future, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, but don't judge.
I think out of respect for my, the person I'm with right now, I wouldn't probably do that. I don't think he would appreciate that. So
yeah, probably not. Have you seen any like celebrity Busta challenge that you really like?
Ooh.
Or Silhouette.
So, you know, was it Chloe? Did she do she did the Busta challenge, didn't she, Chloe? Mm-hmm. And I know she just separated her Instagram from her sister's. I'm a fan of theirs. Like, they have like really like earthy, you know, voices. I just, you know, whatever. Ethereal. But yeah, I watched hers. I thought it was great. I think she looks amazing. She's a grown woman.
She's a grown woman. She can do what she wants.
There was backlash, right?
There was so much backlash with her. Mm-mm. Like, oh my gosh. She was like on some video like crying about it.
Oh yeah, I remember.
I don't know, like I'm sure she was like emotional, but for me, it's like when you cry and then you press record, it kind of like loses me. Like,
I didn't expect that, you saying that, but like, no, facts.
I'm like, sure she was upset, but it's like when you're like, but you're like, record. Like, I can't take this seriously from that point. Like,
I'm sure she was upset or whatever.
Yeah.
But you're right. I could never go on live and like be crying or record myself crying. But maybe she was just in the moment. Some people are, I feel like artists in general are really like, they're, you know, they're extra. You know what I mean? Like, just who they are. So I could kind of see why people do that. Like me personally.
Really?
I can. No. I just think it's just like they're already extra. You know what I'm saying? Like I forgot about that.
So my little like, what's it called, fire alarm?
Yeah,
it's beeping. Yeah, Kevin Samuels says that's like the main like sign of a single woman, and that's facts.
We took it off the wall, but clearly forgot. It's still beeping. Yeah, we need to take the. I should have took the battery out of the thing.
It didn't work, but whatever.
Damn it! Irritating. But no, when Tashe and I were talking about the Silhouette Challenge. I know she was like, well, we're going to try to do, you know, record something. And she tried to go on TikTok and she's like, I don't understand TikTok. And I don't either. Like, I don't know if it's a millennial thing. I don't know. I just don't have time to figure out.
I had a YouTube tutorial on how to do the Silhouette Challenge.
Like, and I was like, let's just use Instagram. Like, it seems a little bit more user-friendly than TikTok. I honestly just do not have the time to figure out TikTok right now. Like,
please watch this video to the end because we're going to show you our bloopers. We did the Silhouette Challenge. Like, the most awkward shit ever like trying to be sexy in silence.
Period. We didn't get it together until the end when they had to play music with it because it was horrendous. Like, but it was so funny. Like, at one time I think my crotch was in your face. Like, that's why I started laughing. At one point, oh my God.
I tried to hit that Meg Thee Stallion like knee stance. I was like, oh no,
knees what are you doing? Not made for that. So like, absolutely not at all. I think overall, like, I think the challenges are cute. Like, I think they're like, once you get to a certain time, like, oh, this is really cute, or you know, whatever.
Yeah.
But then at a certain time, I'm like, I'm over this shit. Like, I'm so tired of saying this. Like, over it. Or like the celebrities that get involved in it too. It just becomes so mainstream that We're just, it's forced down our throats. I'm over it.
I remember like when we were in quarantine. I know some people out there are still in quarantine. Here in Houston, it's iffy. You know,
they don't give a fuck
whether or not we're in quarantine or not. But basically not here in Houston. But I remember when we were like actually shut down, there was a lot of challenges going on where people were doing like the dances. It was like,
oh, the
baby, the tick. Come on, give me some.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And that was getting on my fucking nerves during that time. But
yeah, I really like that song too, and they ruined that song for me.
It was really a challenge. It was just like a trend, I guess.
Yeah, it was like,
that's
when
TikTok became pretty big. I feel like it wasn't big until quarantine.
That's true. And remember how Trump tried to like ban TikTok? What, nigga, what? Like,
that was a failed attempt, but like, it's still around.
I don't even understand the whole concept behind that, but yeah, I just remember thinking like, I told my kids, like, download TikTok, guys, so we can figure it out, but I ain't got the time for that. Like, I just don't. I'm kind of over the challenges, but, and plus, like, remember the body, yaddy, 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 yaddy,
yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy,
you know,
I don't know.
Until we went out to Houston, I think we went to camp. That's the first time I actually ever heard the whole song. Mm-hmm. Like, otherwise, I just only heard the chorus part, the body, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy.
Now, every time it comes on, I'm like,
hey, hey. Body, yaddy, yaddy, yaddy. Like, no.
It's lit.
Man. Oh, speaking of, have you seen the new Cardi B video? Girl.
The...
I don't know the song, actually. The song actually sounded good, but, yeah. Like, I've seen clips, and she's, like, tonguing this girl down. Like,
I was like, okay? I don't know. I don't know how to feel about that.
I was confused, mostly. Like, what's going on here?
Like, what? That was really weird.
Would you ever kiss a girl?
No.
Yeah, I'm sorry. No. I just... Not hey, to it. Each his own.
Yeah, it's just his own.
I personally just like men. Yeah. Like,
I have no problem with girls that kiss girls. Like, do you?
Do your thing. Let them titties hang. You know? Yeah. Personally. I just can't.
Yeah.
It's not my cup of tea.
Yeah.
You know. That was very awkward, though.
Yeah.
I just don't understand.
Yeah, when I watched it in the video, it was just very awkward. I don't know. I was like...
It wasn't as awkward as that Madonna,
Drake,
Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera. Oh, that's what that was on Drake. Oh.
When Madonna gets Drake, was that as an award show?
I think it was. Like he
looked disgusting.
He looked like maybe like her gum transferred into his mouth. I don't know. It was just like he was like.
I don't know. That was really awkward.
It was very weird. Like what the fuck? It was just awkward.
Do you feel like the silhouette challenge is like degrading to women, or you feel like it's just like a fun, you know, TikTok
challenge? I think it's fun. Like,
yeah, me too.
I'm just so over people.
I mean, I think it can be degrading when you're like butt ass naked.
Yeah.
Like I told you, I can see this one young lady's ovaries.
I would never. I couldn't
like,
do that.
I can see it all.
No.
Yeah.
You have to show me this later.
Yeah, she was.
I'm super
naked.
Nosy, so. No, I don't think it's degrading. I don't like how other people try to govern women's bodies. Like, mind your business, you know? I mean, if a woman wants to show her naked ass body, more power to her. I wouldn't do it.
Just know the consequences.
Yeah, and that's the truth. Like, if you do it, then it's a possibility that people, like, anything that you post, people are going to talk about it. They're going to probably have something negative to say about it. Especially, like, with, like, the Chloe thing. Like, you know, I guess they weren't used to seeing her in that light. So, when they did, people were like, oh, you're a young lady, you know?
Was she even, like, provocative in the challenge?
I don't think she was. I thought she looked cute. Like, I mean, you could see, like, a little bit of thigh, a little bit of booty meat. But, like, you couldn't really see.
So, if I'm being real, like, no. If I had a daughter, I wouldn't want her doing the silhouette challenge and being butt-ass naked on the internet. Like, no.
No.
But, no. You know, it's just fun, playful, and it's, like, no harm to it.
No. Like, for me, I always gotta go by this. If I can't post it to my Facebook, because my Facebook is really where I know people, and you know what I mean? Like, other Instagram, Snapchat, I have a prison friend on Snapchat. I don't even know him.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't, if I know that I wouldn't post it to Facebook, then I probably should use some discretion. You know what I mean? Like,
And let's be real, because it's not just women doing this challenge. It's men on there, too, showing they hold it.
Oh, my God. So, I showed Cachet this. I didn't know on Twitter.
My son,
okay. on Twitter, these people are like doing the busset and silhouette challenges, and like they are naked, or like they're showing their bits and pieces, and I'm like, oh my god, there was one just probably just put it over his shoulder. Yeah. Goddamn,
there was one he could wrap it around his body,
basically like, play golf with it. You know, wow. Jesus.
Alrighty then.
No thanks. Absolutely not. Can you imagine being his mom? Like, being the mom that's scrolling through Twitter, like, oh my god, look at Steven. Like, hell no. Ew. Absolutely not.
Wow.
You know what, guys? I'm really glad that we remembered to turn our mic on.
I know.
We have been trashed.
We've been so unprofessional, and we've been forgetting to turn our mic on lately when we do these videos.
Like, guys, we've been...
Yeah.
At one point, there's one that we shot, and it was like, we shot three different times. Like, we forgot to turn something on. We forgot to turn the mic on. It was like, god damn it. Like, it was trash. So, we've been doing that lately. So, I'm glad we turned our mic on. You guys can hear us
Nicole,
a little bit.
If you could, like, create your own challenge, what would it be?
The Good Mom like Challenge.
A what?
I'm just kidding. I said the good mom Challenge. Lies. Let me think. Big titty challenge. No.
Well, guess I'm not doing that challenge.
Natural hair challenge. Oh, okay. That's a good one. Because you can do like slow-mo videos of your natural hair.
You could. That would be cute.
That would be cute. I would do
I like that. We should do that. Natural hair challenge.
What about you?
Bougie bitch challenge.
I'd be out. I am not bougie at all. People say it, but I'm bougie really squad. Not like at all.
People tell me that, and
you're like, yes, I am actually.
I am actually.
Glad you mentioned that.
Thank you for knowing me as a person.
I don't think you're necessarily bougie. I think you just have a very specific like. Sort of like expectation, and there's nothing wrong with that. You know, I really just...
I mean, I'm definitely bougie to an extent. Like, I remember telling my aunt, like, I don't drink, like... She was like, you don't drink dark coffee or, like, black coffee. Mm-hmm. I won't drink just, like, regular coffee. It has to be Starbucks. So that's kind of bougie.
Oh, you only drink Starbucks?
I only drink Starbucks.
But, girl, you don't... Wait, you don't have a coffee maker, do you?
No, because I only drink Starbucks. The fuck?
That's ridiculous. When she has
that's
children.
That's why I agree with the bougie.
Yeah. It's ridiculous. No. Mm-mm.
That's what it is. I only drink Starbucks. I don't drink black coffee.
What else makes you bougie?
I don't know. I mean, I like going to like the upscale spots in Houston, but you know me. You know I don't mind going to the hood either.
She really don't. Wait, we're going to shoot dice next time.
Sometimes.
Yeah, it's lit.
It's a good time.
So we're going to get shot?
Yeah.
Maybe not. I don't know.
Dangerous? What? High crime rate? Let's
You're
do
like,
it.
What? New York City? Let's walk?
What?
Will we get stabbed?
The books. Let's go. Like, I'm down for
it. She really is. I'm here for it.
I'm bougie, but I also love like the hood spots as well. Love it.
Hood spots be lit.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody loves
Uptown,
you there.
Uptown, one of my favorite hookah spots in the city, and it's not bougie. I'll tell you that.
I don't know if I don't mind anything. I'm not like a, I'm just all around. I don't mind anything. Like you can take me, like, that's the thing. I think people have preconceived notions and it's like, have you even met me? Do you know me? Like I'm more of a, like a relaxed type of person. I don't, the only thing is like, I always get like, I feel like up when I think of bougie or bourgeois, like I think of really dressed up spots, bourgeois. I think of really dressed up spots with like white, crisp whites on. And I'm a messy bitch. Like I will be dirty.
Have
like
you been to Trulux?
No. Have you?
It's a, I went the other night. You ain't seeing my story?
Oh,
you
wait. It's
my story all the time.
Okay, like, here you see it. Because I was trying to be nosy this time. I saw it because it was a friend's birthday, right?
Yes.
Who was that?
So it's this girl I met through my friend Nisha.
Okay.
Yeah. So she's really cool. I went to her birthday and it was at Trulux. It's like a steakhouse.
Okay.
Expensive ass spot, but it was.
It was
good.
What did you get?
I got a steak and it was fucking delicious and some like mashed potatoes. It was delicious.
That
like,
sounds good.
Worth every fucking.
How much was it though?
My meal altogether. So I got the steak, the side of mashed potatoes. I also got a margarita. I think all together it was like 80. Actually cheaper there. I was surprised I didn't spend over 100.
It was $80. What kind of steak was it? Did it have gold on it?
It was a medium rare. No.
Because I know you fucking
when lying. I tell you tender steak, juicy, melt in your mouth.
Girl, like, I'd rather eat my fist for was, $80. Are you crazy?
It was delicious and I would pay every motherfucking dime again to get that steak.
Did they even do to-go boxes there?
Yeah.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I've never been to Trulux. I've heard of it, but I've never been, and I, you know.
It's more of like a special occasion. Like
yeah.
V-Day or, you know, Christmas. Yeah, it's birthday. More of a special occasion, yeah. Unless you just a rich bitch out here. Like, it's more of a special occasion type place.
Yeah, no. Have you ever been on a date, like, to a high-end?
To Papado's, yeah. It's somewhat high-end.
Papado's is pretty high-end.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially if I'm not paying.
I went on a date there with, you know, the gentleman I told you about. That was our first date. To Papado's.
Oh, I like
it. It was Papado's. Nice.
Yeah. I've only been there, well, on a date. I've only been to Papado's on a true date once. No,
Papado's
twice.
Papado's is expensive. Like, don't sleep.
It really is. Expensive. And I never go anywhere unless I can afford, like, just in case the date goes bad. Like, I'm not going anywhere unless I can afford it on my own. But
no, Trulux was like propose to you type.
Okay.
Restaurant. Like, they had live music and it was very fancy. Very, like, you're not going in there wearing sweats and like, a hoodie.
Was there a lot of brown people there?
I don't recall. I mean, at our table, obviously, because I'm one of the black people. But yeah. I don't recall, like, who was really around me. But
okay.
It was very nice. Like, waiters, like, on top of it. Like, do you need this? Do you need that?
Yeah.
Like, okay. Which they should be for $80. Like, you know what I mean?
Seriously. Like, I'm sorry, but, like, yeah. No matter where we go, like, the other night, we went out to dinner, and we went to Fish Daddy's. You know what Fish Daddy's is, right? It's, like, and I think it's an affiliate of Cheddar's. They specialize better in seafood, which, and it's really good. And the waiter was so great. Like, we tipped him so well because, like, he was dope. Like, I always do that. If I go to a really good restaurant or any restaurant and I get really good service, like,
yeah,
I'm going to tip you very well. Not just, like, regular. I'm going to tip you over.
Yeah.
You know, we tipped him, like, $20, you know?
Yeah, the 80 was including my tip, actually. So,
okay.
Really, the whole thing. That was
okay.
Tip. But and I tipped, like, $15.
You tipped also?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you tipped 15. It wasn't, like, included in gratuity.
Right.
Okay. I gotcha.
Yeah. I took extra, so yeah. It wasn't that, like, my steak alone was, like, 40.
Oh, my God.
But, no, this was a bomb-ass.
It must have been, the best part of the cow.
It was juicy-ass, bomb-ass steak. Like, it was pretty good, and then this other girl next to me had salmon, and it looked fucking delicious. Like, when I go back, I want the salmon.
Was it blackened salmon?
No, it wasn't. I don't think it was blackened, but it was, like, glistening, and it just looked so...
I have to look.
I was like, damn,
up.
I should have got that.
That sounds dope. You're making me hungry, bitch. Like, I'm starving.
It's a special occasion type place, for sure.
Ooh, yeah. Speaking of, too, I know, like, V-Day is coming up for all of you guys. I was trying to get that last drip out, you know what I'm saying?
There's a lot left. There's no last drip.
I'm lit, so just FYI.
Just FYI, we shot a podcast before this, so we've already been drinking.
Pretty much.
If you're wondering.
So I'm pretty lit. I really was trying to get that last little drop out of there.
She said. I'm like, girl, there's no point. I'm like, what are you doing? Look how much is left.
My bad.
She was trying to get the last drop out of that. I'm like, what?
My bad. But yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do for Valentine's Day. I hope it's fun. Or whatever.
It'll be fun.
I hope so. I have not had a Valentine's in 4 years. Like, I mean, I've had, like, people send me, like, flowers 1 year or, you know, stuff like that. I even had coworkers give me, like, a little gift. I remember you were like, girl, does she like you? Yes.
Oh. Wait, she gave you something on Valentine's Day?
Yeah, she gave me something on Valentine's
Day,
too.
That's so fucking weird.
I was like, whatever.
I think she was low-key being propositioned for a threesome at one point because that was so weird.
We have to talk to you guys about the weird energy that happens around us sometimes. Like, sometimes people will be propositioning us for the craziest stuff and we're like, what do we look like here? Like, what? Like, do we, like, we're the sisterhood of boring. Like,
What do we look like? Like, we have been in drug dealers, like...
Because we have a good ass time.
We do. We do. We've literally been in a drug dealer's, like, whole entire section before.
We...
I was like, bitch, are they dealing drugs?
Here in Houston, right? What?
Yes.
Damn,
I can't remember where that was. It was actually fun.
It was when I lived in Pearland.
Yes, because we went there with Chastity before, and we went there
with Chastity. Just,
Chastity came and she visited us, and she was there, but we didn't go. In that, okay. Yeah. Where
she
was that?
She visited me when I was in Pearland, I guess.
Wait, was it? Yeah, because she was down. She came to Houston, and I came down.
After my lease is up, I want to move back to Pearland so bad.
I miss Pearland. Yeah. It was nice.
A nice area. Close to everything. Such a nice suburb.
Yeah. You didn't have to travel through, like, a million hoods and, like, just to get somewhere.
I can't remember the name of, either there or Katie. I can't remember the name of the place that we went to, but yeah, I remember we were at a drug dealer section.
Yeah, he was like, you guys want to come sit in our section? We were like, I guess. So we sit down and...
We wanted to sit, so...
We were like okay. And then we're sitting there and I'm like, girl, why he got a backpack? What the hell? And the whole night people were just coming up there. I was like, well, I guess we're gonna, and then like, you guys want some hookah? We're like, we're gonna get our own, but sure, you know. It was interesting. I'm like, did we just like, what?
He did give us his hookah, like,
and he was nice.
Hookah free. I'm there. Period.
He was nice. But
he was nice.
What?
He was doing something very illegal, but
hey, you know, to each his own, you know what I mean? But it's like, goddamn, like, he could have been like, hi, I'm a drug dealer. Would you guys like to go sit in that section? Then we could have made that decision on our own, you know?
Yeah.
It was very weird.
Well, damn. We got way off subject.
We did. That's life. We actually... Well...
Go ahead, Nicole.
The
my
beep?
Fucking bar.
I know. I fucking hate it.
Well, we're going to put the bloopers of our Silly Wet Challenge at the end of this video.
You guys definitely tell us what you think about
it. Watch
it. The thing is, like, we like to have fun and, like, we laugh a lot. Yeah. So, but yeah, you should definitely watch it and laugh along with us.
Yeah.
Tell us what you think. If you did a silhouette challenge, tag us. Let us know. You know, we're everywhere. Know. Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter. Our Twitter's a little bit, but we're doing our
Maybe
best.
Maybe not Twitter.
but yeah, make sure you guys definitely like and subscribe. We would love that. You know, you little bitches.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.